1943. Somewhere in Nazi-occupied territory are five men, misfits from the four corners of the world, the strangest five, with nothing in common but their incredible daring. Enlisted against their will in a monstrous crusade against the fascist fortress at Dubrovnik, are their extraordinary talents equal to the task of ripping out its secret? Now, their lives are linked, their movements timed to the minute, their actions triggered to the second, for they alone shared the secret. An impossible scheme. The war itself depended on the precise timing of 1 second. You will live as these men launch the secret invasion. Mace, the mad major, obsessed by the knowledge that he could not fail.
Abandoned? This mission will be abandoned only when all six of us are dead.
Roca, the master criminal, destined to be a hero. He lived only for the challenge of high adventure.
You lead your troops into battle against the Germans, or my friend here will kill you.
Scanlan, the demolition demon. He could blow the crystal off a watch, yet still keep it running. Bell, the forger. He could duplicate any signature and make it look better than the original.
I can reproduce this stuff in my sleep.
Durrell, the assassin. He didn't need a war to kill. With him, murder was an instinct. And Mila, the girl who gave her flesh and blood, more than her own life, to these heroes from hell. These men, an impossible feat against staggering odds. And no matter what the price, no matter what the punishment, they had to keep their secret. At a secret place, at a secret time, you will live. As these men launch the secret invasion.
As the Third Reich reeled under the hammer blows of the advancing Allied and Russian armies, a secret combined American-British operation was launched. Purpose? Penetrate Norgard, Germany's most closely guarded missile base, and bring out the world's foremost rocket engineer, Dr. Erich von Heinken. Simultaneously, a Russian tank column raced toward the same objective. Spearheading the Allied team, American OSS officer David Mitchell, posing as Wehrmacht Major Heinrich Strasser.
Den Feind. Und mein Bettchen. Wir können nach Norgard zurückfahren. Sie können es sperren. Wir spät. Ach.
Du hast immer ein paar Minuten Zeit, dann gehen wir rein.
front. Well, how'd it go, Mitch? We all set?
Yeah, I guess so. Dr. Van Heinken's pick four of his top aides will also want out. They'll make a run for it as soon as the air attack starts.
Schedule for 800 tomorrow.
Fine. What about the British team?
They'll jump at 0400. Meet us at the rock quarry. Mitch, one more thing. They changed escape line.
Change? Or how?
I don't know. Static wiped out our transmission.
Jamming?
I don't think so. We changed frequencies every time we had...
Somebody must have tipped him.
Who?
Van Heinken. Split up. We'll meet at the rock quarry. Let's give it a try.
Sturmbannführer?
Ja.
Einen haben wir.
Bitte?
Ja.
Das ist gut.
Abwarten. Norgang.
Machen Sie auf.
Mach das Tor auf.
Mehr Sauerstoffzufuhr in die Triebwerke 3 und 4. Hessel! Ausschalten! Was gibt's denn so dringendes, Obersturmbannführer?
Kennen Sie diesen Mann?
Nein. Wer ist das?
Ich habe heute Abend erfahren, dass Hauptsturmführer Strasser amerikanischer OSS-Offizier ist. Es ist geplant, Sie und vier Ihrer Assistenten zu entführen. Von jetzt an, Dr. von Heinken, stehen Sie und Blücher Tag und Nacht unter Bewachung.
Wilcox, your father phoned me last night. His lordship asked me to look after you. That won't be necessary, sir. And I'll thank his lordship to keep his bloody nose out of my affair. You airsick, Donald?
Happened to any of us, sir.
We're coming up to target, gentlemen.
up and disengage your parachute, sir. I'll collect the others.
Password.
Over here, Major Griggs.
Where are the others?
They're dead. What's a new escape plan?
Wilcox.
Sir.
Explain your new escape plan to Captain Mitchell.
We dropped three pairs of men on the way in to form a chain of contact points along our escape line.
I thought we were going to be flown out.
Yes, but if the plane can't get in at point A, there'll be men hidden at points B and C to help us make it back to Allied lines.
That sounds all right.
One more thing. The Russians have moved up much faster than we expected.
It could be a real free-for-all.
The new orders are, if we can't have von Heinken, no one's to have him. Clear?
Yes, but sir...
Take cover!
Carrier. Dump that searchlight.
Captain Mitchell! Over here!
The Major. He's dead.
All right, let's break it up. His ranking officer, I assume, command. Let's get their weapons.
Just a minute! Excuse me, sir. But Allied intelligence put this phase of the operation into our hands.
It's a combined operation.
But your unit's gone. So now Lieutenant Wilcox takes command.
Well, he's off to a hell of a start.
I beg your pardon, sir. But that was uncalled for.
Well, so was the death of a good professional soldier because of some stupid amateur.
Captain Mitchell, I do have my orders. Amateur or not, I intend to complete our end of the operation, with or without you.
Without me, you don't have von Heinken. Now, you get something straight, Lieutenant. You just do your job, and I'll do mine.
Fair enough. All right, you know what to do.
Come on, you heard the Lieutenant. Jump to it!
Verbinden Sie mich mit Obersturmbannführer Hessels Wohnung, bitte.
Ja?
Obersturmbannführer, ich melde, der Gefangene ist soeben verstorben.
Hat er noch was gesagt?
Nein. Vielleicht hat er wirklich die Wahrheit gesagt und es waren nur vier.
Aber wir haben nur drei. Die Patrouillen sollen weitersuchen.
Jawohl, Obersturmbannführer.
Das ist genug.
Es ist spät, Rolf. Kurt ist krank gewesen, ich möchte gehen.
Noch nicht, setz dich. Ich möchte noch etwas mit dir besprechen.
Na schön, aber wirklich nur ein paar Minuten.
Du erinnerst dich doch an Hauptsturmführer Strasser.
Strasser?
Ja, vom Führerhauptquartier in Berlin. Du musst ihn hier gesehen haben.
Ach ja, natürlich. Aber nur ein paar Mal und entweder warst du dabei oder Dr. von Heinken. Warum?
Das ist im Moment nicht wichtig.
Heinken slips out as you'd planned.
Then he'll wait for us. After last night, I doubt he'll be able to get out, even if he wanted to. That's it. Let's go.
Shoulders in the basement.
To see me, Doctor? Yes. Last night, Major Hessel said he found out about you. I wonder how he found out. If you think I informed, you're wrong. Either way, you're coming with me. In the truck.
Keep going. Come on, let's go!
Corporal Morse.
He's dead.
Von Dr. von Heinken.
Organisieren Sie sofort eine Suchpatrouille.
All right, let's go. Get your gear and pile in.
Sergeant, we'll send a two-man patrol on ahead of us.
How? On foot?
My colleagues.
All right, hold it right there. Hands behind your head. McBee, O'Connell, check the truck. Van Heinken!
My aides have come as we planned.
And what about the others?
Families, their relatives. They were afraid to leave them to Hessel. I said they could come along.
No. There won't be room for everybody on the plane.
Captain Mitchell, I agreed to leave voluntarily because I felt the Allies offered some hope for a sane world. But if we all can't go, then none of us will go.
Well, you haven't got a choice, Doctor. Now get back in that carrier.
May I have a word with you, Captain? We can't just leave the others behind.
Now, you listen to me. My job is to take Dr. von Heinken and his aides to our lines. I made no deal for those civilians.
But if they're captured, they'll be killed.
Now, you try to get this through your head, Lieutenant. Dr. von Heinken knows more about rockets than any man alive. The Germans and the Russians want them, and they're breathing down our necks. Now, we've got to travel fast and light.
Look, Captain, I do understand. And if there isn't enough room on the plane, I'll make it through with them some other way. It'll be my responsibility.
Okay. Your responsibility.
All right, all of you in the truck. Come on, we're moving out. Hurry it up!
You men get in the truck, too. Come on, let's go.
McBee, you take the car. O'Connell, get the carrier.
Well, what are you standing there for? Come on, move it. I said move it.
Is that how you treat children, you liberator?
What are you doing here?
I'm his mother. Let go of me.
Let her go, Captain.
I asked what she's doing here. She's Hessel's mistress, isn't she?
I know who she is.
Well, now I know who turned us in.
She knew nothing of your part in this. Only that she was to join us when the time came.
She must have had a pretty good deal with Hessel. Why is she leaving?
It's not like that. You must take my word for it. I've known her for a long time.
Good. That's good.
Товарищ майор! Музыка?
Вы уверены, что это его сигнал?
Да, товарищ майор.
Попробуйте его поймать. Я хотел бы знать, откуда это.
Sie waren hier. Englisch. Und gucken Sie mal die Radspuren. Das waren mindestens zwei große Fahrzeuge und ein kleineres. Mhm. Ja, was ist damit?
Norgard meldet eben. Von Heinken, Burger, Gross, Wolf und Blücher werden mit ihren Familien vermisst.
Und?
Und Frau Gerhardt.
Funken Sie an alle Kontrollposten. Jedes Fahrzeug wird angehalten und durchsucht.
All right, Lieutenant. What do we do now?
We'll never get around them, sir. Not in this terrain. We could try bluffing our way past.
Are you willing to risk the lives of your civilians if the bluff doesn't work?
Well, perhaps we could leave them behind, knock out the checkpoint, then bring them through.
Well, our plan's got guts, but they got a tank. Unless...
I assure you, Captain, I have no professional jealousy.
Sergeant, come with me. We'll get a couple of men.
Bring me all the extra gas cans, a length of rope, and a detonator. Turn that radio off.
Music makes everything seem more cheerful.
Yeah, it does make everything cheerful. But not now, Blucher. Not now. Now turn it off.
товарищ майор, перваус.
Уставьте. Теб я разнан облавлене. Он не верно больше не в Нёргат, и она отправляется на запад. Запчите главную квартиру, что мы начинаем преследование.
Хорошо.
Pilgrims aboard and get ready to roll.
Right.
Well, Doctor, it might not be as sophisticated as your rocket, but it should do the trick.
Kent! Come.
Alle Kontrollposten außer Rot 0 haben geantwortet.
Rot 0. Hier.
Posten Rot 0, ab!
Get the runway markers lined up.
Corporal, put the tracks in the woods.
What's that?
Cody.
Cody. Well, do you realize that
plane is 20 minutes late.
That's got nothing to do with it. You take them.
Captain? Algarad has had some training as a nurse.
I'm okay.
Let me see.
All right, but hurry. That plane should be here any minute.
Lieutenant, what will happen to our families if there isn't room enough?
We'll radio from the plane and try to lay on another one as soon as possible.
That's fair enough, isn't it, Doctor? Or are you still hoping Hessel will get here in time?
Captain, I told you before I did not betray you.
Well, if you didn't, somebody did in this big, happy family of yours.
I refuse to believe that.
Easy. Are you sure you've had experience at this?
Enough. A German officer's wife is expected to make herself useful.
Well, where is he? Your husband?
Buried someplace in Russia. Kurt, go back to the truck. Kurt, please go back. I will be there in a moment.
What happened to your boy?
The war.
Well, doesn't he talk?
Really, and only to me. The SS was going to send him to a youth camp, but Major Hess arranged matters so I could keep him with me.
I see. I'm sorry.
No, you are not. It's the same as every other soul.
Keep everybody out of sight.
Big enough to carry us all.
Can you manage, Captain?
Yeah.
Lieutenant, hold him.
Truck. He'll radio in our position and the place will be swarming with SS. Right.
Come on, quickly. Get the truck. Quickly, please.
Die Luftwaffe meldet soeben, dass in der Nähe von Christoph eine alliierte Maschine beim Landen abgeschossen worden ist.
Christoph? Gut. Ohne Flugzeug werden Sie es nicht schaffen.
Nach Christoph.
Sergeant, I want you to keep three men on watch at all times.
The lieutenant has already given that order, sir. And I told the men to take their rations now. If that's all right, sir.
As soon as you're through with that, I want to know exactly how much gas you got left.
Yes, sir.
Until we get to our lines.
Surely you're not suggesting we let these people starve.
Just stating a fact.
have a man posted up there in that loft.
He might be here a while.
Captain, I feel rather responsible for this whole situation. You took a stand, Lieutenant. I'll stick to it. What's the story on the gasoline,
sir? Worse than we thought, sir. We're dead low on petrol. Barely enough for 10, maybe 15 kilometers.
According to the map, it's almost 15 kilometers northwest of Point B and just over 200 kilometers southwest to our line. Well, Sergeant, you better siphon what gasoline we have into the weapons carrier.
Just a moment. What exactly do you have in mind?
We'll go ahead to Point B, pick up what extra fuel and supplies we can. Also, try to radio for a plane to pick us up in the morning. Unless you've got a better idea, we ought to get started.
Well, Sergeant, what are you waiting for?
Yes, sir.
Was ist?
Nichts. Der Suchtrupp hat nichts gefunden. Ich habe Ihre Instruktionen weitergegeben.
Diesem Strasser muss doch jetzt bald das Benzin ausgehen.
Und was ist, wenn er hier in der Nähe Benzin auftreibt?
Genau. Wir werden uns in zivilisiertere Gegenden begeben. Still.
It's Sunday. You did say 7:30, didn't you?
Yes.
Who asked us here?
It's from Jarvis. Henley wounded. This lad trustworthy will lead you to us. But it could be a trap.
There's only one way to find out. Show us the way.
Thank you.
Henley!
Jarvis!
Да, его еще раз поймайте, позовите меня.
Quick. Do what you can for him.
Of course.
You had no luck. You walked into an ambush.
Sir? Jarvis and Henley. Where are they?
They're dead.
Well, I better get the weapons carrier to cover.
What now? The lieutenant wounded, I suppose you command.
Command what?
A bunch of civilians? Soldiers running out of ammunition? Trucks out of fuel? And you go no farther?
Unless you can reach into your scientific bag and pull out some gasoline.
I do not know this area, but maybe someplace around here we could find more fuel.
Well, that's a big maybe. Wait until it gets light and then we'll look.
He's coming round.
He'll have some blood, but the bullet passed through.
Oh, that's good. Can I help?
Would you lift him up?
How are you feeling, sir?
I could use a drink.
You better sleep now. I will be nearby if you need me.
Don't you worry, miss. I'll stay with him.
Lieutenant, you better take some of your own medicine. You see to it, Sergeant.
Right, sir. Now, come along, sir. Let's not have any arguments.
Captain Mitchell. I think you should get some rest.
I'd better relieve the man on watch.
I haven't had a chance to thank you for saving my life, Sergeant.
You don't have to thank me, sir.
I've made a terrible showing of myself, haven't I?
Oh, no, sir. If anybody was to ask me, I'd say you conducted yourself like an officer and a gentleman.
A gentleman. Thank you, Sergeant.
Can we talk?
Yeah.
What will happen tomorrow if you cannot find gasoline?
Well, we'll do the best we can.
The best we can? What does that mean?
You know what that means.
The rest of us will be left behind. You really don't care, do you? What is it? What's wrong?
Nothing.
Tell me, what is it? Please tell me. You must tell me.
Okay. I can't promise to take the rest of you along.
But we'll take Kurt. I don't care for myself. Promise you will take Kurt. He's just a little boy. You must take Kurt.
Don't you understand? I can't promise you anything.
Thank God I can still feel. For you, it's too late. Inside, you are dead.
No sign of him. Don't you worry. We'll find him.
He's right, miss. Just you leave it to us. It's all right, sir. There's no one else.
All right, now. Where'd you go?
You're frightening him.
Then you ask him.
Kurt, we were very worried. Where did you go?
What'd he say?
He knew we needed gasoline. He says he knows a place.
Where?
Do you think we can trust the lad?
He doesn't lie.
Well?
He wants me to ask you if he did well.
Yes, Kurt. You did very well.
Kessinger wartet auf seine Verpflegung. Wo ist das Zeug?
Ich habe keinerlei Befehl erhalten.
Es gehen Gerüchte über den Schwarzmarkt um.
Ich schwöre Ihnen, davon weiß ich nichts.
Na schön. Dann werde ich die Sachen selbst abliefern. Steigen Sie auf.
Soll ich Ihren Wagen vorfahren lassen?
Augenblick noch. Haben die Leute was gefunden?
Noch nichts, Obersturmbannführer.
Wer ist das?
Ich weiß es nicht, Obersturmbannführer.
Thank you.
Get in the truck, quick. Everything's all right, sir. Right, pick up your stuff and get in the truck, quick. Come on, hurry it up.
How's the lieutenant?
He's all right.
Lieutenant, you better ride in the truck. You shut that damn thing off. Just a minute. Give me that radio.
It's mine.
Give me the radio.
See what you've done.
You know what this is?
It's a transmitter.
Stand where you are.
You were sending signals. To whom?
I begged you to listen to me. The Russians offered so much for me, for both of us.
The Russians?
Yes, and they should be close by now.
You. You betrayed us.
Now, McBee!
Corporal.
Sorry. I didn't know.
Now, forget it. I was wrong, too.
All right, let's get moving.
Where's Kurt?
The truck. Come on.
Should be up just ahead.
Your yanks have broken through. Could be the end of our bloody rainbow.
Was ist?
Sie sind vor kurzem abgehauen.
Sie fahren direkt auf die alliierte Front zu. Und zwar durch den Fluss.
Something's coming. Hide the radio and get down.
What do you mean, called off?
That's right, sir. The whole operation. It's been cancelled.
Why?
Political considerations, that's the way they put it. Seems the Russians have taken Norgut, but they didn't find the man they're looking for. They also suspect that we have him. So the Allied brass in London made a deal. This side of the river, including those scientists, belongs to the Russians.
It's one hell of a finale, isn't it? What am I supposed to do with them? Just leave them? The hell with them. They're not gonna get them.
You serious, Captain?
I never made contact with you, understood? I never got the new orders.
Well, yes, sir. If you say so, sir.
If the Russians want von Heinken and his pals, they're gonna have to deal for him later.
Huh? German patrol approaching.
How far back?
About a mile and moving fast. We never outrun them.
Wilcox, you get the civilians back into the truck. Make it through the woods to the river.
What will you do?
Dig in and try to delay them.
No, I'll stay here.
No, you won't. You make it through, we'll meet you at the river. O'Connell, you drive. The rest of you follow me.
It's best, sir. You take the civilians.
In the truck. In the truck.
Here's your cap.
They're on the way, sir. Uh-huh. And here they come. And here come our Russian pals. Well, they stopped.
No good, sir. It'd just dig deeper.
I'm sorry.
Me too.
Better get that out of here faster. Those Russian tanks are right behind us.
Captain, perhaps if you all push.
Yeah, well, let's give it a try.
Alice here.
Damn it.
Red tanks on their tail. He wants cover.
Cover?
All right, when the red shows, stand by to fire. But near misses only, understand?
Tell him to get a move on.